I want to take a look at two examples that sometimes cause problems for students. Here we have f of x equals sine to the fourth x, and here we have the function f of x equals sine x to the fourth. These are two entirely different functions with entirely different derivatives. I think it's a little bit more obvious when there are parentheses here, but sometimes some textbooks leave off the parentheses, which can make it even more difficult to distinguish between these two functions. So let's go ahead and take a look at this first function here, f of x equals sine to the fourth x. The first thing we need to recognize here is that this is the same as sine x raised to the fourth power. So we do have a composite function, and therefore we'll have to apply the chain rule. So in these types of problems, the most important thing is to identify the inner function and let the inner function equal u. So for this function, sine x is going to be equal to u. And let's record that over here, which means we can now rewrite the function in terms of u as u to the fourth. So now we can apply the extended power rule that has the chain rule built in to determine f prime of x. So f prime of x is going to be equal to the derivative with respect to u times u prime. So n times u to the n minus 1 would be the derivative of the outer function, and u prime would be the derivative of the inner function. So we'd have 4 u to the third times u prime is our derivative, but we want our derivative in terms of x. So we'll substitute sine x for u, and we'll have to determine u prime. Well, u prime would be the derivative of sine x, which is cosine x. So we'll have f prime of x equals 4 times sine x to the third, and then u prime is equal to cosine x. Let's go ahead and write this one more time. We have f prime of x is equal to, we'd have 4 sine to the third x cosine x. We could express this derivative in a different form using the double angle identity for sine, but we're going to go ahead and leave it in this form for this example. Now again, let's go ahead and compare this to the derivative of sine x to the fourth. This is a composite function, so the inner function here would be x to the fourth. So if we let u equal x to the fourth, we can rewrite the given function in terms of u as just sine u. And now to determine f prime of x, we'll apply the derivative formula for sine u, which includes the chain rule, as we see here. So we have the derivative of sine u with respect to u, that's going to be cosine u times u prime. So we have the derivative of the outer function times the derivative of the inner function. So notice how we will have to determine u prime. Well, u prime would be 4x to the third. So now we'll rewrite our derivative function in terms of x rather than u. So f prime of x is going to be equal to cosine u, but u is x to the fourth, and u prime is 4x cubed. Let's go ahead and rearrange these terms. Let's write it as 4x cubed cosine x to the fourth. So it is important that we can distinguish between the two different functions given in this video. I hope you found these examples helpful.